Hello students, welcome back to our journey in quantum mechanics. Today we'll be discussing one important equation which is a basic of quantum mechanics. Though it is basic, in your future study you'll be coming across this equation while you are solving different equations of motion for electrons in different electronic devices. So without wasting our time, let me start with our topic, that is Schrodinger's time-independent wave equation. What is this Schrodinger wave equation? Who gave this equation? Before we are going to study something, generally we develop the curiosity that who gave this equation, what is the significance. So let me tell you who gave this equation and what is the significance of this equation. This equation was given by an Austrian physicist, Erwin Schrödinger, in the year 1926. Now, what is the significance of this equation? Why should we learn this equation? In some of our previous lectures, what we have seen that a moving matter particle is always associated with a wave, and it also possesses a dual nature like our light wave. So based on this concept, Schrödinger, he thought if this matter wave is behaving like our light wave and it is a wave, then there must be some similarity between the classical waves and this matter wave. So based on these assumptions, he told that this de Broglie wave or matter wave resembles the classical wave like our heat wave and sound wave, all those. Then he thought if it is resembling with some classical wave, then it should obey the wave equations what are given for our classical waves. And this is the basics based on which he developed the wave mechanics. And in this mechanics, he incorporated the de Broglie wave into general classical wave equation. Then he developed this Schrödinger wave equation. The importance of this Schrödinger wave equation is it describes the behavior of matter wave, how it is moving, what is its behavior, all those can be known by solving this Schrödinger wave equation. Further, there are two equations given by Schrödinger. One is time independent wave equation and the second one is time dependent wave equation. In your syllabus, we have only this Schrödinger's time independent wave equation. Today we'll just see what is exactly this equation, and in the next class we'll go for the derivation. So this is the one dimensional Schrödinger time independent wave equation. Here the particle is moving in a single direction. Here I have taken it is in the x direction. So this is the one dimensional Schrödinger's time independent wave equation. We'll do the derivation in the next class. Now this is the Schrödinger time independent wave equation in 3D. Here this psi or the wave function that depends on three coordinates, the particle is moving in a three dimension. Here this wave function is in the form of xyz, where this xyz are the position coordinates of the wave function. And this delta square over here, that is nothing but del square by del x square plus del square by del y square plus del square by del z square. And you know that this is our Laplacian operator. So this is one dimensional Schrödinger equation and this is three dimensional Schrödinger's time independent wave equation. We'll meet in the next class with the derivation. Up to that, thank you and have a good day. Bye.